film or book? That's what we're discussing today on Not Good at Normal.
Hey, great, you found us. Thanks for tuning in. This is Not Good at Normal.
Thanks for joining us. This is T, and today we're going to discuss some books that were made into movies and probably going to be considered period pieces because most of them, well, let's face it, most movies about lesbianism, that's hard to say, and bisexualism, if there is such a thing in movies, is considered a period piece. There's so many movies where it's almost like a trope or cliche. It's like, it's a period piece, they get in trouble, or one of them dies, or they want a baby and they break up because the other one doesn't want a baby, or one goes off and becomes with a man again. It's the same old thing. You know, it's always the same kind of story. So we're going to try to, it's probably going to be about like a 3 or 4 part series, maybe even more, but we're going to discuss some of the books and then those that have been turned into movies. I'm a reader. I love books. I love historic books. And I like to read the book first and then find the movie and usually end up liking the book better. So we're going to start today with Carol, otherwise known as The Price of Salt, by Patricia Highsmith. The book came out in 1952, and the movie, it's hard to believe it was 6 years ago, 2015, probably the best known of the three we're going to discuss today. This movie was very well received. It had won some awards, and it was nominated for a few Oscars. I don't think it won any Oscars, but if it did, it might have been just not one of the more well-known ones. But, I mean, it was very stylized. It was very, I went into it expecting a little more, but knowing that I love Cate Blanchett so much that I knew at least I would get a great performance. And it was. She's fantastic. It was just a very nice, pleasant kind of slice of life in a period in time that was perhaps more simplistic, but so much harder if you were different, if you were against the norm or not good at normal. And this certainly shows that being homosexual in any way is not normal. You can lose your children. You can any number of things. It was just totally looked down upon, and you had to marry the man and have a family and do all the things that were expected of you because you were a woman. And that's what this is about. Let's watch this part here.
It wouldn't be advisable
at
under
school, in an office.
The issue is not where necessarily.
Surely a visit.
Carol, these are serious allegations. Forcing contact before the hearing, you risk inviting further scrutiny concerning your conduct.
My conduct? Jesus Christ. I'm a mother, for God's sake. I see.
Do you?
No. There's nothing moral about keeping Rindy from me.
And of course, the character Carol is outraged because her husband wants to take her child away from her because she is morally different. So that was the time period. This was the early 50s, and things didn't change for several more decades. Several. So overall, a good story. I didn't care for the book. I liked the movie better. So worth reading, but definitely worth seeing the movie with Cate Blanchett and Rooney Mara as the much younger woman girl that Carol falls for. And as always, I like to throw in a little bit of titillation for you. So in a way, Carol and Therese are both trying to figure out what they want from life. If they decide to leave their family and the life they've known because it's stifling, or Therese, who doesn't want just to marry the guy who she's been seeing for a while. So next up we have Tipping the Velvet. This is by Sarah Waters, and it came out in, I believe, 1998, 99, somewhere right in there. It is set in the 1880s, and this was when it comes to discussing sex, talking about sex, or even showing it on television. So this period, first time in her life, a male impersonator. She being from a very small seaside town, she sort of starts falling for this woman, not really sure why. She goes to see the show nightly, and she gets to know her, becomes friends with her, and then she's offered a job with her touring as like maybe her dresser or something. And then she things in back alleys. And yeah. And so in this one, I enjoyed both the book and the miniseries pretty equally, I believe. They were very similar. The kind of outline of the series really followed the book, so it was very enjoyable. So definitely worth reading and watching this miniseries if you can find it. And our final book that was made into a movie, again by Sarah Waters, is called Fingersmith. This is my the least favorite. I did not enjoy the book. The movie was not much better. It was so complicated. And this is called a crime drama, but it's very, very difficult to get into, involved with, to enjoy. There were so many characters, and toward the end, there were so many plot twists. You would think it would be entertaining, especially for me, because I love history. It's historical. It's a, you know, I'm on this kick with watching like English shows, and it just seemed like it would be really cool. I love crime dramas and true crime, but this was just too hard for me to get involved in. And for me to explain it to you, oh my gosh, I would probably need an hour, because the twists and turns, they ended up growing up in an orphanage, and the one is supposed to be rich, and they're going to take advantage of her and throw her in a mental institution, but then the other one goes to the mental institution, and it ends up they're both from the orphanage or something. I don't know. It was just very complicated. And I didn't think these two characters, these actresses, had much chemistry together, but, I mean, that's just me. So, anyway, here's three books and movies that you perhaps would enjoy watching, reading. If you have any that you want to suggest, please leave a comment, any that you've liked or what your thoughts were on these particular movies, let me know. And as always, please, if you like, then like the video, subscribe if you want, and I'm going to try to do more content more frequently. Also, leave a comment as to what type of video that you would like to see in the coming weeks. I've got a few lined up, but I've always want to hear your comments, what your thoughts are, what you think maybe I could do better, or what you'd like to see. As always, thanks for watching. Not good at normal.